Okay, so we introduced the concept of circulation density in relation to integrating a vector field around a curve C. But remember when we defined line integrals of vector fields, this originally came from integrating F dot the unit tangent vector of C and integrating with respect to arc length. So this is related to circulation. But remember, when we introduced line integrals, we also mentioned the possibility of instead using the unit normal vector here. And so if we do that, the resulting concept will be related to flux. So in this video, we'll discuss the concept of flux density or divergence. So this will describe how a fluid is flowing. So if we have this is our vector field, we have some region. The divergence will describe how a fluid is flowing out of, so in or out of, as opposed to, so is flowing out of a region as opposed to how it's flowing around. So circulation is about how it's flowing around the edge of a region. Divergence is about how it's flowing out of a region. And it'll measure measures the extent to which a fluid is expanding or compressing at a point. So recall, a fluid is a liquid or a gas. Well, liquids are incompressible. So if our vector field is the velocity field, if our vector field is the velocity field of a liquid, the divergence will always be zero. But for gases, the divergence can be very interesting. Okay, so let's sort of repeat the type of analysis we did for discussing circulation density. So if we have a small rectangle of width delta x and height delta y, again, we have x y plus delta y, x plus delta x comma y, and then this is our f. So to talk about how sort of the outward flow of this, we want to measure along these directions. So this will be f dot negative j. This will be f dot I. Here we'll take f dot j. And here we'll take f dot negative I. So the approximate outward flow along each edge is approximately, so on the bottom, we have f of xy dot negative j. And then again, we want to multiply this by the length of that segment, so times delta x. And so let me write f xy is m xy I plus n xy j. So this will give us negative n xy delta x. The top, we get f of x, y plus delta y. Then we dot that with j, and then times delta x. And then this will give us n of x, y plus delta y, delta x. The left edge, I have f of x, y, dot negative I delta y. And so this will give us negative mxy delta y. And then on the right, we'll have f x plus delta x y dot I delta y. And so that will be m x plus delta x y times delta y. So now when we add all of these up, okay, so top plus bottom is n x y plus delta y minus nxy is delta x, and that's approximately del n by del y times delta y, and then that times delta x. Then for the, if we do left plus right, that's m x plus delta x comma y minus m x y delta y, and that is approximately del m by del x delta y. All right, so then we add these together. So the total flux, flux is the Latin word for flow along the boundary. Is the sum of these two things is del m by del x plus del n by del y, delta x delta y, and then the flux density or flux per unit area is when we divide, is what we get when we divide this expression by the area delta x delta y. So let me write that as a definition. Definition, the divergence or flux density. Divergence is sort of the more mathematical term, flux densities. Sort of inspired by physics, of a vector field F equals M X Y I plus n xyj at a point xy is the expression div f equals del m by del x plus del n by del y. And again, as with the circulation density, note that this is a scalar. This is also denoted nabla dot f, because that's, again, it's a slight abuse of notation, but so if nabla is del by del xi plus del by del yj, so if we dot that with mi plus nj, this becomes del m by del x, and then these two go together, so plus del n by del y.